Let's discuss about proteobacteria, which includes your phototrophic, hemolithotrophic, and methanotrophic bacteria. Before we go any further, we should know a few important definitions which will be used throughout these slides. Autotroph. An autotroph or producer is an organism that produces complex organic compounds such as carbohydrates, fats, and proteins from simple substances present in its surrounding, generally using energy from light, that is photosynthesis, or inorganic chemical reactions, that is chemosynthesis. They are the producers in a food chain, such as plants or land or algae in water. They can be photoautotrophs or chemoautotrophs. Phototrophs are the organisms that carry out photon capture to acquire energy, that is, use light as an energy source to carry out various cellular metabolic processes, while chemotrophs utilize electron donors as a source of energy, whether from organic or inorganic sources. In simple terms, chemotrophs are organisms that obtain energy by the oxidation of electron donors in their environment. These molecules can be organic, and those who use these organic material or organic molecules are called as chemoorganotrophs, or these molecules can be inorganic. And organisms which use these inorganic molecules are called as chemolithotrophs. Many prokaryotes, bacteria as well as archaea, obtain their energy from the oxidation of reduced inorganic compounds such as hydrogen, ammonia, nitrite, sulfide, elemental sulfur, hydrogen, and Fe2 ions. These organisms can derive all their cellular carbon from carbon dioxide, and they are thus able to grow without any organic compound and without light. Such microorganisms are called chemolithotrophs or chemoautotrophs. Methanotrophs. They are sometimes called as methanophiles. They are prokaryotes that are able to metabolize methane as their only source of carbon and energy. They can grow aerobically or anaerobically and require single carbon compound to survive. Anoxygenic photosynthesis. Some group of bacteria can capture light energy and convert it to ATP without the production of oxygen, through anoxygenic photosynthesis. Anoxygenic phototrophs have photosynthetic pigments called bacteriochlorophylls, which are similar to chlorophyll found in eukaryotes. A meromictic lake has layers of water that do not intermix. Meromictic lake stratify because they have denser, usually saline water in the bottom and less, usually fresh water near the surface. Let us discuss about proteobacteria. On the basis of 16S RNA gene sequencing, over 80 phyla of bacteria are currently known. Out of these phyla, one is named Proteobacteria. It is by far the largest and the most metabolically diverse, including in it a wide variety of pathogens such as Escherichia, Salmonella, Vibrio, Helicobacter, and many other notable genera. Bacteria responsible for nitrogen fixation are also included in this group. Thus, this phylum includes majority of bacteria having medical and agricultural significance. As a group, they are all gram-negative. The phylum Proteobacteria is further divided into five classes: Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Delta and Epsilon. Let's discuss about purple phototrophic bacteria. The key genera includes Chromatium, Ectotrichosporia, Rhodobacter, Rhodospirilla.
सर लाइट बंद कर दो, रिकॉर्डिंग चल रही है।
लेट्स टॉक अबाउट the purple phototrophic bacteria. The key genera in this includes Chromatium, Ectrocheirodosporia, Rhodobacter, and Rhodosporum. They carry out an oxygenic photosynthesis, that is, no oxygen is released. They are morphologically diverse group, and the classification of these organisms has been established along phylogenetic, morphological, and physiological lines. Different genera fall within the alpha, beta, or gamma proteobacteria. They contain bacteriochlorophyll and carotenoid pigments, and together these pigments give purple bacteria their spectacular color, usually purple, red, or orange. They produce intracytoplasmic photosynthetic membrane systems into which these pigments are inserted. These membranes can be of various arrangements, but in all cases originate from invaginations of the cytoplasmic membrane. The internal membranes allow purple bacteria to increase the amount of pigment they contain and to thus better utilize the available light. When the cells are grown at high light intensities, the photosynthetic membranes are few and pigment contents are low. By contrast, at low intensities, these cells are packed with membranes and pigments. These purple sulfur bacteria utilize hydrogen sulfide or H2S as an electron donor for carbon dioxide reduction in photosynthesis. The hydrogen sulfide or H2S is oxidized to elemental sulfur that is stored in globules inside the cells. The sulfur later disappears as it is oxidized to sulfate SO4-. They are generally found in illuminated anoxic zones of lakes and other aquatic habitats where hydrogen sulfide accumulates, that is, locations also known as sulfur springs. The most favorable lakes for development of these bacteria are meromictic lakes. The examples include Chromatium, Ocne, Theospirillum, Dinensi, Cupidia, Rosea. Unlike other purple sulfur bacteria, the genera Ectrocheirodosporia and Haloroidospira produces sulfur, elemental sulfur, from the oxidation of hydrogen sulfide. They do that outside rather than inside the cell. Example includes Ectothio rhodospiria mobilis. The purple non-sulfur bacteria is called because it was originally thought that they were unable to use hydrogen sulfide as an electron donor for the reduction of carbon dioxide to cell material. All these isolated thus far are either alpha or beta proteobacteria. The hydrogen sulfide can be used by most species in this group, although the level ideal for purple sulfur bacteria, 1 to 3 millimolar, are typically toxic to most of these non-sulfur bacteria. They can also grow anaerobically in the dark using fermentative or anaerobic respiratory metabolism. And most can grow aerobically in darkness by respiration. They are nutritionally diverse and can use fatty, organic, or amino acids. They can use sugars, alcohols, and even aromatic compounds like benzoate or toluene as carbon source. Enrichment and isolation of these bacterial cells is easy using a mineral salt medium supplemented with an organic acid as carbon source. Let's discuss the nitrifying bacteria. The key genera includes the Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter. Many species of these bacteria are chemolithotrophs, that is, organisms that can use inorganic electron donors as energy source. Most chemolithotrophs are also capable of autotrophic growth and in this way share a major physiological trait with anoxygenic phototrophic bacteria and cyanobacteria. Bacteria is able to grow cumulotropically at the expense of reduced inorganic nitrogenous compound are called as nitrifying bacteria. These are the ammonia and nitrite oxidizers. Phylogenetically, the majority of nitrifying bacteria are scattered among four of the proteobacteria classes, alpha, beta, gamma, and delta. The genus Nitrospiria forms its own phylum of bacteria and is related to other nitrifying bacteria in a metabolic sense only. Nevertheless, ecological studies of nitrification suggest that Nitrospiria is the most abundant nitrifying bacterium in nature. No chemolithotrope is known that carries out the complete oxidation of NH3 to nitrate or NO3 negative. Thus, nitrification results from the sequential activities of two physiological groups of organisms. These are the ammonia oxidizing bacteria and nitrite oxidizing bacteria. The ammonia oxidizing bacteria, which oxidizes NH to nitrite or NO2, and the nitrite oxidizing bacteria, which oxidizes NO2 NO3. Ammonia oxidizing bacteria typically have genus names beginning in nitroso, whereas genus names of nitrate producing begins with nitro. Many species of nitrifying bacteria have internal membrane stacks that closely resembles the photosynthetic membranes found in their close phylogenetic relatives, the purple phototrophic bacteria and the methano-oxidizing methanotrophic bacteria. The membranes are the location of key enzymes in nitrification, ammonia monooxygenase, which oxidizes NH3 to hydroxylamine, NHOH, and nitrite oxaloreductase, which oxidizes NO2 negative. They are widespread in soil and water. They are present in highest numbers in habitat where NH is abundant, such as sites with extensive protein decomposition or ammonification, and also in sewage treatment facilities. Nitrifying bacteria develop specially well in lakes and streams that receives inputs of sewage or other wastewaters because these are frequently high in NH3. Let's discuss the sulfur and iron oxidizing bacteria. The key genera includes Thiobacillus, Actromatium, Acidothiobacillus, Pygetum. There are two broad ecological classes of sulfur oxidizing bacteria that exist. Those which lives at neutral pH and those which lives at a very high acidic pH. Thiobacillus are related genera containing several gram-negative broad shape, protobacteria, indistinguishable morphologically from most other gram-negative rods. Electron donors, most commonly used by the sulfur chemolithotropes, are S2S, S, and thiosulfate, S2O3. The oxidation of these substrates generate sulfuric acid. One highly acidophilic species, Acidothiobacillus peroxidans, can also grow chemolithotropically by the oxidation of Fe2 positive and is a major biological agent for the oxidation of this metal. Acrimatium is a spherical sulfur oxidizing chemolithotrope that is common in freshwater sediments containing HS. Large cocci that can have diameters of 10 to 100 micrometer. Acrimatium is a species of gamma protobacteria and is specifically related to purple sulfur bacteria. Cells of Acrimatium stores SO internally. The granules later disappear as it is oxidized to SO4 to negative. Pegiatra. Organisms of this genus are filamentous, gliding, sulfur oxidizing, gamma proteobacteria. They are found in nature primarily in habitats that are rich in H2S, such as sulfur springs, decaying seaweed beds, mud layers of lakes, and waters polluted with sewage and hydrothermal vents. An interesting habitat is the rhizosphere of plants like rice, italis, and other swamp plants living in flooded and hence anoxic soils. Diploga and Theotrix. Cuploca is a large filamentous sulfur oxidizing chemolithotrope that forms cell bundles surrounded by a common sheath. The location example includes the ocean floors off the coast of South America. The cells of Cuploca can accumulate huge amount of NO3 intracellularly, and this NO3 can then support extended period of anaerobic respiration with S2S as electron donor. Theotrix is a filamentous sulfur oxidizing organism in which the filaments, they group together at their ends by way of holdfast to form cell arrangements called rosettes. Let's discuss the hydrogen oxidizing bacteria. The key genera includes Ralstonia paracoccus. Many bacteria can grow with hydrogen as sole electron donor and oxygen or O2 as electron acceptor in their energy metabolism. Here, the delta G in this reaction is minus 237 kilojoules, and the reaction is 2 hydrogen plus half O2 will give H2O. Most of these organisms, known collectively as hydrogen bacteria, can also grow autotrophically using reactions of the Calvin cycle to incorporate carbon dioxide. Different hydrogen oxidizing proteobacteria are scattered among alpha, beta, and gamma subclasses. Both gram-positive and gram-negative hydrogen bacteria are known, with the best studies representatives classified in the genera Rolstonia, Pseudomonas, and Paracoccus. Paracoccus denitrificans can also oxidize hydrogen anaerobically with nitrate. This nitrate, or NO3, acts as an electron acceptor, forming N2, that is, the reaction is denitrification, and has been particularly well studied for its bioenergetics of electron transport and generation of proton motive force. Most hydrogen bacteria grow best under microaerophilic conditions, that is 5 to 10% oxygen, because hydrogenases are typically oxygen sensitive. The element nickel, Ni2+, must be present in the medium for chemolithotrophic growth of hydrogen bacteria, because virtually all hydrogenases contains nickel, that is Ni2+, as a key metal cofactor. Some hydrogen bacteria can grow aerobically on carbon monoxide as electron donor. These are called as carboxidotrophic bacteria, which grow autotrophically using the Calvin cycle to fix CO2 generated from the oxidation of CO. Electrons from oxidation of CO2 to CO2 by the enzymes carbon monoxide dehydrogenase travel through an electron transport chain that forms a proton motive force. All genera are straight or slightly curved gram negatives. They are Q chemoorganotrophic rods with polar flagella. The common genera are Pseudomonas, Commomonas, Ralstonia, and Burkholderia. Other important genera include Xanthomonas, Zugloia, and Gluconobacter. The distinguishing characteristics of Pseudomonas group includes an obligately respiratory metabolism, the absence of gas formation from glucose, and a positive oxidase test. These help in distinguishing Pseudomonas from enteric bacteria. Many can still grow under anoxic conditions with nitrate, fumarate, or many of the other electron acceptors that support anaerobic respiration. Some species utilizes over 100 different compounds. Ecologically important in soil and water, they are responsible for the degradation of many low molecular weight compounds derived from breakdown of plants and animal materials in oxic habitats. They are also capable of catabolizing many xenobiotics. Some of them are pathogenic also. The human pathogen, Florissant Pseudomonas, the species Pseudomonas aeruginosa, causes UTI and RTI, urinary tract disease and respiratory tract diseases in humans. The I stands for infection. Also common in patients receiving treatment for severe burns or other traumatic skin damage, and in people suffering from cystic fibrosis. Pseudomonas aeruginosa is not an obligate pathogen, but instead it is an opportunistic pathogen. These microorganisms have started showing antibiotic resistance due to the transfer of resistance plasmid from various antibiotics which are being given to different microbes. They are known plant pathogens, that is phytopathogens. These includes Pseudomonas, Ralstonia, and Burkholderia, and genus Xanthomonas. They frequently inhabit non-host plants in which disease symptoms are not apparent, and from there are transmitted to host plants and initiate infection. They also produces plant toxins, lytic enzymes, plant growth factors, and other substances that destroy or distort plant tissue. For example, Pseudomonas syringae is typically isolated from leaves showing chlorotic or yellowing lesions, whereas Pseudomonas marginalis, a typical soft rot pathogen, infects the stems and shoots, but they rarely infect the leaves. Cymomonas are gram-negative rods which carry out a vigorous fermentation of sugar to ethanol. They are distinct from other Pseudomonas by its strictly fermentative metabolism. Cymomonas show phylogenetic affiliation with Pseudomonas. Like other Pseudomonas, it employs the Entner-Durov pathway for glucose catabolism. Cymomonas carries out alcoholic fermentation of various plant saps, and in many tropical areas of South and Central America, Africa, and Asia, it is found in various fermented beverages made from plant saps, such as pulak, or again palm sap, sugarcane juice, and honey. Let's talk about the acetic acid bacteria. The key genera includes Acetobacter and Leucanobacter. They comprise gram-negative, obligately aerobic, motile rods that carry out the incomplete oxidation of alcohols and sugars, leading to the accumulation of organic acids as end products. They are tolerant of acidic conditions, and most strains can grow well at pH values lower than 5. Alpha proteobacteria, comprising both peritrichously flagellated Acetobacter and polarly flagellated Leucanobacter organisms. They have their use in fermenting of fruit juice, such as hard cider or wine or in beer. They can be recognized on calcium carbonate agar plates, CaCO3 plates, containing ethanol, because the acetic acid produced dissolves and causes a clearing of the otherwise insoluble calcium carbonate. They carry out an incomplete oxidation of some higher alcohols and sugars. For instance, glucose is oxidized to gluconic acid, galactose to galactonic acid, arginose to arginic acid, and so on. This property of underoxidation is exploited in the industrial manufacture of ascorbic acid, that is, vitamin C.